Folks, Luca, Sharper Trades. The day was overall positive in the market. We had a little bit of a pullback after one of the Fed's member made a comment of uncertainties. As the market get better, they will start revising some of their policies and something like that. So anyway, it caused a little bit of tension. As you can see here, there was some pullback. But then in the close market bounced up and in the after hour market is up a little bit. So this is bullish. Our volume is good, picked up a little bit. 410, 420, next targets, 480 MA, and then down here at 393. Let's take a look at the individual stocks. Starting with the AMD, and some of the things obviously that we talked about today. AMD. We mentioned last week that was making this base above 73 with dark pool activities. And so far, if you took the trade, it's working. Good consolidation above 79, popped today a little bit. And the resistance here is the 50 simple moving average and 85. If it's through that level, then the next targets will be 88, 92. And then 99 is my last target channel stop. The support for me is the 79 area, the 20, 200 simple the moving average. Box swings is still in consolidation. I like this chart, and the fact that someone is gonna buy this company tells at this stage at least that there is still a solid base. The support is 23 and 22. Targets 26, 28, 30. Cliff is done. Cliff technically it worked briefly here and then broke the support yesterday and it was done. So this is off the list with even or a minor loss when it broke the like yesterday, 3 days ago, popped and then a steep pullback on downward volume. That wasn't good. He needed to hold the support at the Monday low, which was 19.35. The following day, open lower, 19.39, a few penny right around the level, but then it broke the support and it went down. So that was the indication the pressure was going to increase. And most importantly, broke this breakout point. This is the area where we were looking at right there. Yeah. Broke and now is right below it. So before this start working again, is to come back above 1880 area, 19 area, then we could see higher prices. This is a classic commodity related company. Now price is still high, but it's anyway affected by that price. And I want to see it again back above 19 before it can go higher. Right now, this is off the list. Coursera, 4 days, 5 days up. Trade the 15-minute chart. I think this is done for now. As started to break the VWP. Secondary support is the 52, I believe, 52 level, this low, 53. And the channel bottom. Moving forward, if he extends 68 to 65, 69, 74, one more. 80. Cisco is in consolidation. This is for me, is done to profit. Yesterday, consolidation today. Broke, it didn't break anything. It moved below yesterday low with the downward volume increase. This is still in consolidation. I want to see a break above 30, 53 before it can go higher. This reached the first target, minor profit, was 3-4%. And oh, we'll take it. 55 and 58 next targets. Support 52 and 50. Fuel cell didn't work. This is off the list. It's still in consolidation. Looked like it was breaking out. It fell. For this to start work briefly one day, and then yesterday stabilized, but it was too weak. Didn't have enough volume. and today opened a little higher, but broke yesterday low, as you can see, 13.45, and then went down. So this is done. Frack, keep an eye on it. I like this base that's been forming. First of all, rolled over massive from 39, dumped to 780. It's been consolidating, rolled over this day down to 734, and then there was the reversal day. And a hammer, bullish, technical start bullish with the good volume. And today had a good pop, most importantly, closed above the drop high at 1080. It closed at 1099. Keep an eye on it. This can get interesting because of one thing. There is a big gap, $20+ gap. And once there is a gap, price will try to fill it. I'm looking for the 21 simple moving average and possibly the 34 EMA. That's a classic pattern. After a gap down, price will try to fill the gap up to the 34 EMA. But as a start, I'm looking for 1450, 17, 19, 21, and then 23. The support is today low. FTCV, good base, pop today, decent volume. Look for an extension, 1470, 6, and 16. Above that, 1730 and 1889, if it gets going. The support is today low. GGB. GGB is bullish in the steel. This is working. It's a swing idea. I took profit today. So this is the nice trade for me, at least. But, you know, this is just the beginning of a move. It's pressing this resistance. Volume is good. I want to see a break hold above the 550 area. If it does, then my next target is 650, and possibly 7712 area. Anyway, as long as it remains above the 513 area, that's dark productivity, is bullish. I'm looking for a re-entry. Let's see if I do it. HIMX, breakout. Today reported earnings, earning guidance or something to that extent. A good move with volume, but then a weak close. Volume is good, it's an inverted hammer. What we don't want to see with an inverted hammer is a lower opening and a break of today low. That happens, it will pull back further to retest the 80 and the 50. So this one is to come back above 15, take out this high, 1673, and then we're going to see the target, 17, possibly 19 and 22. Support again, 80 and 50 SMA. Copen, it's disappointing. I mean, it's all over the place. It's actually was working and then not. Was working and then not. So it's still in consolidation. What I don't like it is 2 days in a row of downward volume. If it breaks below the 80 EMA and doesn't recover, it will go lower and it will be painful. Today was up six, seven percent, and now it's down 6%. This is the kind of percent gain and loss that we deal with this particular company. So if you're not comfortable, don't trade it. I'm looking for a move back above and stick 12, precisely this high, 1167. If we get that, then it's gonna go higher. 1330, 16, 1840, those are the targets. Support 1050, breaking. And 950. Navy continues slowly, gradually. It's 1451. It's very quiet, but quiet is good. You know, it doesn't get noticed, doesn't make big move. As long as it makes higher highs and higher lows, I'm happy with that. Technicals remain bullish. 15 is the first target, above that 1640 and 18. Support is 14 and 1350. NVST, keep an eye on this one because today it broke out all-time high. All-time high breakout, yes. And got a bounce, tested. Tested. And what's important is the intraday action that closed above the VWP, the dotted line. It's still there. So we need to see this dotted line to continue hold, that's the VWP, and I want to see move above 44. It breaks above 44 and holds. Next target is 45, 46.50, and 48. The support for me is 43, precisely today low, 42.80. OUST, good day trade. Popped, reached the resistance, target at 9.26, extended a little bit, pull back, retest the channel bottom. I never like when it breaks the VWP, but this recovered not too long later, after. And then when it broke back above the VWP, stabilized and then run again to the target at 10.29 and then came as high as 11.10, 11.23. Then I pulled back, broke the VWP, broke the channel bottom at that point, was down. It does maintain a bullish look because of the bullish kicker and the volume especially. This company is well placed in the robotics of self-driving car, all this automation. They provide the eyes, if I understand correctly. But anyway, it's well placed. And an analyst, they gave a target of 17. So that speaks volume. So my target's moving forward, if you're swinging it, 12.60, 14, 15.50, and 17.26. The support is 9 and 8.30. Pins, fantastic. I mean, this is a company I mentioned several times. I have a long-term position. However, today I took profit, reached my target at 85, took profit. And there was a big dark pool activity at 84.33. And it closed below it and looked like my pullback. No, I will look for additional, for re-entries and that sort of thing. And if it breaks 85.30 and holds, then it will try to go higher. 92, 101, 110. Anyway, happy with the good profit today. And let's see how it does move forward. This is a bullish pattern. Channel, breakout. I will look for a pullback again. The support 78 and the 34 EMA at 74. RELL. We haven't talked much about it. This is a day trade in the focus list. Again, it didn't do much, so that's why I didn't talk about it. But had a rolled over consolidation, popped into the close, another pullback, and then in the after market is up a little bit. But it's in a key sector, the electronic component, and the volume today is good, 1.1 million. Doesn't trade a lot of shares. In fact, the past few days, very little, 20,000, 40,000. So it's slow float and cautious. But anyway, keep an eye on it because the volume is good and it could try to extend. If it does, 870, 10, 12, 13. The support for me is the 8MA at 670. SOS. SOS is an extremely difficult chart to trade. There was talk in the trading room yesterday about some kind of movement. I didn't quite understand it. But anyway, today was in the focus list. Didn't do much. After the opening, I saw that productivity, something like 3.1 million dark productivity at 580. So it needed to close above that level. It went up and down, up and down, up and down. Tried twice to break the 617 area. Even into the close, it tried again and failed. And then in the after hour market went down. So this is below the dark pool level, and that's a bearish indication. Now we'll have to see how tomorrow it opens and how it behaves moving forward. The technicals are bullish with this big volume bar and above 5, but it's below the 50 simple moving average. So until it breaks and holds the 50, this will possibly pull back further. So if it breaks this level, looking for 7, 850, 1040. The support for me is the 580 area, and then below that is today low, 520. SQ swing idea. I have a position with this one. Few days ago, I spotted that productivity at 1,211,211 dollars. That was the level where it was. Come on. With this bullish engulfing, decent volume picked up the following day, traded below the 50 simple the moving average, and yesterday and today popped. So that is the first target, was also day trade, and then I pulled back a little bit. I'm looking for 167, 267, 286, and 300, 309 to be precise. This is a bullish pattern with a rising channel, fantastic rising channel, a breakout with decent volume, and we need to see more, especially break and hold above this high at 253. And those are the targets. Support is the 50 simple moving average and 220. TH was a day trade that worked really well right after the open. It went explosive. It ran to two targets immediately after the open, few minutes, reached the first target at 350, and then the second target at 4. That's a dollar almost in few minutes. When you're talking a $3 stock, that's significant percentage. Anyway, then reached the target, and then a pullback. A pullback that took out the BWP that was steep, and then never recovered. Nevertheless, because of the volume, let's see, because of the volume that came in the past few days, could get interesting, could actually have a stronger next couple of days, maybe more. If he extends, let's see what we're looking for. These were some of the day trade lines. 470, 560, 660, 770, and one more. 9. The support today low and yesterday low. Twitter mentioned yesterday, printing a breakout, confirming today. Let's see if it does extend. It's still below this resistance of 74. So I'm going to look for that as the next target and then see what it does at the level. Above that 80, this is the all-time high. And then eventually 87, 95, and 102. Technicals are bullish, volume is good. It's holding above the moving averages, all of them. So those are the support. That's your support, okay, basically 64. UNFI is a swing that it's struggling a little bit. They dropped and then recovered, but it's an indecision. I wanted to see a bigger body and green. Instead, we had a thin body, which makes a doge indecision in red. The volume is bullish. It's at support. It's holding the primary support at 34. Secondary support is 32. For me, presence of lower shadows is bullish. It's okay as long as it continues to close above the 34 level. Ideally, 36. That's the area I want to see. And then eventually, we need to see a breakout stick of this trend line, and that would be the 36 level. Targets are 38, 41, 45, 49. Support 34 and 32. VIRT maintains a bullish look, reached the target at 32, pull back the test. It needs to break and hold the 32, 35 area. 34 and 37, my next two targets, support 80 May and 30. Woozy keeps on giving, as was mentioned multiple times. Here, pull back, popped. Today, some of you, they traded, made a good move to 30, was the all-time high. Yeah, all-time high. The most recent high was this at 30.65. Today came as high as 31.20. My next target, if this thing extends, 32, 36, and 40. Support 27, today low, let's see, today low, 27, and then 24. And finally, Excel. Excel was a day trade, worked really well. So right after the open, a bullish move that brought price to the target at 954.59, consolidated with the VWP holding nicely, and then reached the next target at 1039. That was another dollar almost. Pulled back to test the VWP, held nicely, popped again, then 211. 1077, and then came down, number volume increase, broke the primer, the first support, held the VWP, the area needed to hold, and then it fell. So at that point, it was down when it broke below the VWP and didn't recover. Big volume past couple of days. So this is an inverted MA with the week close, but could extend. So I will look for a move back above nine, and then next targets. Now those are all tight because of day trade activity. But let's say 10:40, 12, 13:50, and then the 50 simple moving average. Those are my targets. Well, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading. See you tomorrow.